Good morning, children. Suprabhat, namaste. I am Anupama teacher and I teach social studies. Hope you all are doing well and you all are safe. Well, children, before I go to my lesson or start my lesson, I want to speak to you something. Wash your hands regularly with soap and water. Sanitize. Listen to your parents. Drink plenty of water. And stay home, stay safe. These are the precautions that we should take in the present situation of the COVID-19.
Namaste, children. As I told you, we'll be beginning our social studies first lesson today, that is globes and maps. And today we are going to first, I'll be explaining you about a very, very interesting topic, that is globes. Well, before I begin my explanation, I would like to ask you the one question. What is the shape of the globe? Well, I guess each and every one of you have seen the globe in the fourth grade. Well, you will say, ma'am, the globe is round in shape. Yes, it's absolutely correct. A globe is round in shape. It's spherical in shape. I'll be get back to you with the meaning of the spherical. Don't worry. It's spherical in shape. Well, children, our earth appears like a blue and white ball of marble. Our earth appears like a blue and white ball of marble. But children, you know, thousands of years ago, it was impossible to know what the world is like because the ground below their feet was more or less flat. So what did the people guess? What did the people thought? People thought that the whole world to be flat. The earth is spherical in shape. Thousands of years ago, people guessed that the whole world to be flat. Well, children, what is the meaning of the word guessed? The meaning of the word guess means conclude something without the correct or sufficient information. They were not sure, but they guessed. They thought, yes, the whole world would be flat. It was only after Portuguese explorer Ferdinand Magellan went around the earth that the earth's actual shape was known. Who was Ferdinand Magellan, children? Ferdinand Magellan was a Portuguese explorer who set on a voyage. Well, children, the meaning of the word voyage is a long journey on sea. Who set on a voyage, he started from the one place, and after 3 years, he returned to the same place where it had started, which proved that the earth is round. So what is the meaning? The earth is spherical in shape. What is the meaning of the word spherical? Spherical means shaped like a spear. Shaped like a spear. So I think it's very clear. I have explained very clearly about the earth, children. Now let us go to our next important topic, that is globes. Yes. Yes, children, globes. See, children, we cannot see the whole earth because it is very big. It is difficult to study the earth without seeing it completely. Yes or no, you tell? When we have to study about the earth, when you have to study about the physical features of the earth, when you have to study about the certain things about the whole world or the earth, is it possible for us to do it? Because it is very, very so big. And moreover, if we want to know about the earth, we cannot do it without seeing it completely. So, How can we do that then? How we will know about the earth? A model of the earth can help us? Exactly? Yes or no? So children, such a model of the earth is called globe. So what is a globe? A globe is an exact model of the earth showing the current shape and locations of the continents, oceans and the seas. Like earth, a globe is round in shape. It is an exact model of the earth. It is round in shape. Even you can see in the picture there, children. It is flattened at its poles just the way the earth is. Well, children, what is the meaning of the word flattened? Flattened means to make or become flat or flatter. At its poles, children, regarding the poles we will be explaining you, we will be getting to know in your next lesson, that is in the latitudes and longitudes, children. So it is flattened at its poles. Now what will happen? A rod passes through the two points of a globe. This represents the axis of the earth on which the earth rotates. The earth will be rotating, children. It takes 24 hours for it revolves around the sun. It takes 24 hours. The same way the earth rotates. That I will be explaining in my next slide. Don't worry. So a globe can represent the earth in a simple and accurate way. It shows the physical features of the earth like seas, ocean, mountains and continents and boundaries of various countries and their actual location on the earth. So children, definitely the globe has certain advantages. How it is? It helps us in studying geography. Well, you must be wondering, what is the meaning of the word geography? Children, the social studies, usually it consists of the three branches, children: history, civics and geography. Now, what is the geography it usually deals with? See, the study of the physical features of the earth and its atmosphere and of human activity, including the distribution of population, resources and political and economic activities, is called geography. Anyhow, you people will know about the subjects once you go to the higher classes, children. So nothing to worry about it. So a globe, it helps us in studying about the geography. And in the same way, what are the other advantages of a globe? A globe helps pilots and sailors to plan air and sea routes. It helps the pilots to plan air routes and it helps the sailors to plan sea routes. And the third one is, a globe helps us to understand the occurrence of day and night. Well, I'll explain you this. See, it is unable to travel around an object, right? The earth turns on its own axis once in every 24 hours. The earth turns on its own axis once in every 24 hours. And during this time, the sun only shines on the half of the earth that is facing the sun. On the other side of the planet, it is night then. So we have day and night because of the earth turns on its own axis. I think I explained you very clearly how does the globe helps us in understanding the occurrence of day and night. Well, again, children, I am repeating. The earth turns on its own axis once in every 24 hours. And during this time, the sun only shines on the half of the earth that is facing the sun. On the other side of the planet, it is then night. So we have day and night because of the earth turns on its own axis. Well, children, along with the advantages, we also have certain limitations of a globe. A globe also has certain disadvantages. What are they? Now, just let us look at it. Well, it is very difficult to make and carry a globe. Yes, children. The space is limited and the details of a place cannot be shown. Details of each and every place around the world of the world cannot be shown in a detailed form on a globe, children. And the most important thing is that we cannot see the whole world at one glance. If we have to see the other half of the earth, we have to turn the globe. You understand? We have to turn the globe to the other side and we should see. So children, I think so. It is very clear now what is meant by the globe, what are the advantages of a globe and what are the limitations of the globe. Now there are certain the new words along with the meanings about this particular topic, children. And what are the new words we have learned today? The first one is spherical. What is the first word, children? Spherical. Spherical means shaped like a sphere. Well, the meaning of the word sphere is an object shaped like a round ball, that is called sphere. So you know the earth is spherical in shape. So meaning of the word spherical is shaped like a sphere, and the meaning of the word sphere is an object shaped like a round ball. Well, the next word what we have learned is explorer. Well, the Portuguese explorer Ferdinand Magellan, where our explorer is a person who travels to new places to learn about them. Yes, explorer, he likes to travel to new places to learn about them. Now, next word what we have learned is flattened. What is that word, children? Flattened. Flattened means to make or become flat or flatter. And finally, the next word we have learned is axis. What is an axis? An imaginary line on which a body rotates. An imaginary line on which a body rotates. Well, children, before I come to your assessment parts or about the question and answers part about this particular topic globe, I would just recapitulate what are the things that we have learned about the globe today. First, we have learned about the earth. The earth is spherical shape, means which is round in shape. Thousands of years ago, people guessed that the whole world to be flat. The earth's actual shape is known only after the Ferdinand Magellan, a Portuguese explorer, went around the earth. What is a globe? A globe is an exact model of the earth showing the current shape and location of the continents, oceans and seas. It is flattened at its poles. Well, a rod passes through the two points of the globe, which shows the axis of the earth on which the earth rotates. The globe has certain advantages. What are the advantages? It helps in studying geography. It helps pilots and sailors plan air and sea routes. It helps us to understand the occurrence of the day and night. Along with the advantages, even a globe has a certain limitations or disadvantages. What are they? It is difficult to make and carry a globe. The space is limited and details of a place cannot be shown at the same time, and we cannot see the whole world at one glance. So this is the one. So today the particular topic about the globe we have learnt in detailed form. Now I'll be giving you the assessments. I'll be giving you the fill in the blanks and the question answers about the topic globe only. I expect you all to please write down these answers, take out your social classwork notebooks and write down the answers in your classwork notebooks. Well, children, the first one is fill in the blanks. Our earth is dash in shape. On a globe, the space is limited. I'm very sorry, I told you the answer. On a globe, the space is dash. A globe is a model of dash. Now we come to the question and answers part. Well, answer the following questions. Question number one, when was the earth's actual shape known? What is the shape of the earth? What is a globe? How is a globe useful? What are the limitations of a globe? And remember, children, I will surely be discussing you about the question and answers in my next, before I go to my next topic in my next section, about the fill in the blanks and the question answers. Definitely I will discuss the answers of this all with you in my next session before I go to my next topic, that is maps. But before that, I expect all of you to kindly attempt all the question and answers and the fill in the blanks given to you. Please keep a note of all this in your classwork notebooks. Well, children, I hope you liked today's session. Please note down all the things what are I told you, question and answers and the fill-ups. I'll be seeing you in my next session. Bye, children.